everyone. My name is Brittany, and we're so excited you're joining us today. Today, we're talking about the story of Jesus and the woman at the well. In our story today, this woman is looking in all the wrong places to get her needs met. But she soon learns that Jesus is the only one who can meet her deepest needs. And we can trust that Jesus wants to meet our needs as well. That's why today we're saying, every day, I can trust Jesus. We're gonna start things off by singing a song together. So let's go ahead, stand up, sing this out with us as loud as you can.
Made the moon. Jesus made the stars. Jesus.
You guys sounded so awesome. Thank you for singing along with us, and now we're gonna take some time to watch a Bible story together. Like I said earlier, today's story is about Jesus and the woman at the well, so let's check it out.
It was a scorching hot day. Jesus was traveling and stopped in Samaria to rest. Under the hot sun, Jesus sat by a well. He was thirsty and hoping someone could help him get a drink. Soon, a woman from Samaria came to the well to draw water. Jesus asked her for a drink. The woman was too shocked to give him water because Jesus was Jewish, and Jewish people did not talk to or hang out with Samaritans. Jesus said,
"It's okay. If you really knew who I am, you would be asking me for water."
"What? You don't even have a bucket. How could you get me water? Hang down into the well by your feet and get water by the handful?"
Jesus could see she was confused.
"Everyone who drinks water from this well will be thirsty again. But I have come to share a living water that will satisfy your thirst forever."
Living water? On a hot day like this, it sounds too good to be true.
"Okay, please give me this living water so I won't be thirsty anymore."
Then Jesus said something she wasn't expecting.
"It's not just water you're looking for. I know that you are lonely and thirsty for friendship."
She had never told anyone about her loneliness. How did this man know this? He seemed like a smart man of God, so she decided to ask him a question that had been on her mind.
"Sir, Samaritans worship on a mountain. Jewish people say we should worship in a temple. Which one is the right answer?"
Jesus answered her,
"That's in the past. Soon, true worshipers will worship the Father in spirit and in truth, anytime, anywhere."
"I know that Christ the Messiah is coming soon. I'm sure he'll explain the rules to us when he gets here."
"Dear woman, I am the Messiah."
The woman could not believe her eyes. The same man who asked her for water, knew everything about her, and told her she could worship anywhere, was the Messiah. She was so excited to tell everyone that she had met Jesus that she'd left her water jar behind at the well. Because of the woman's story, the Samaritans asked Jesus to stay with them. So Jesus stayed for 2 more days, sharing his good news with them.
Jesus was talking to the Samaritan woman about living water that you drink and are never thirsty again. She was probably a bit confused because she had never heard of water like this. And obviously, we know now that Jesus was not talking about actual liquid water. He was talking about something much greater. Our friend, Justice, is going to be talking to us a little bit more about our story right now, so let's take a look.
There are a few things that we can't live without, and water is one of those things. We need water to survive. Without it, we die. Just like water, we all have some deeper needs that you can't see. We need to be loved. We need to be accepted, we need happiness, and we need to feel appreciated. The problem is, we typically look for these things in other people, and the truth is, we will never find them there. We need a true friend who can do all of this. Remember the woman in our story today? When the woman tried to get all that she needed from other people, it was like her cup had holes in it. It didn't work. She tried to be filled up by other people, and ultimately she was left empty. We've all done this with other people around us, like our friends or family. We go to friend number one, and that doesn't work. We go to friend number two. She's nice, but doesn't invite you to her birthday party. You still need love. You try getting all the love you need from a sibling. They're fun to be with, but they don't always want to play with you. We try to get attention from other people all the time by making a joke, doing something, or wearing certain clothes. We think, if I could only be friends with that person, I could be happy. Or if I ever lost a friend, I don't know what I would do. We try to be filled up and get everything we need from someone else, but we're still left empty. Before we become a part of God's family, we are like this old cup. We're full of holes, and no matter what we do, we will ultimately be empty inside. But because of Jesus and all he did for us, we can be a part of God's family. And when we are a part of God's family, we are a new person. The Bible says that the old is gone. And the new has come. But we don't just become a new person, we have a new relationship and a new source to fill us up. Now we can go to Jesus to fill us up with the love, acceptance, and everything else that we need. That's why we say every day, I can trust Jesus. No matter what life is like for you at home, at school, or in your neighborhood, Jesus loves you and he wants to be your very best friend.
When we only look to our friends or family for all the love and acceptance we need, we will always come up empty. Jesus is the only one who can truly fulfill our needs in our life. It's important to understand that Jesus is our true source. All of our other friends and family are great, but Jesus is the only one who can really meet our needs. Have you ever looked to someone else to give you all the love you need? And if so, who was it and why did you look to them? I would encourage you to talk with your parent or small group leader about that, and then take a few minutes talking about why it's important to look to Jesus for the love, acceptance, joy, peace, and everything else that we need. Remember that every day we can trust Jesus. So that's it for this week, and thank you so much for joining us, and we'll see you next time.